How I will dissolve?
By watching the one who wants to dissolve. Who is the one who wants to dissolve? And why does he want to dissolve? And if he is really serious and honest, why has he not already dissolved till now? Surely there is somebody keeping him protected and safe. Who is protecting him? Who is keeping him safe? Maybe the one who says, I want to dissolve, is equally the one who is keeping himself safe. See, there are pleasures in remaining as one is. The ego does not exist for nothing. It exists because the I derives pleasure from its usual activities. As long as you are not fed up of those pleasures, as long as you do not see through those pleasures, why would there be any dissolution at all? The dissolution will not happen because you will not allow it to happen. Dissolution is a heavy word. What is it that you are actually saying? What you are saying is, I do not want to remain as I am. Right? But why are you the way you are? Because there is pleasure in being the way you are. Unless you address those pleasures, you will not let any change happen. And change cannot be forced. Change is a byproduct of seeing or realization. Maybe those pleasures are good for you. Then why force yourself to dissolve? The fellow is having a good time and some teacher or sage is urging him, dissolve, dissolve. He is saying, I am watching a nice movie and enjoying popcorn with my girlfriend. Why the hell should I dissolve? So, first of all, figure out the arguments that you have against dissolution. And we all have pretty strong arguments against dissolution. Maybe those arguments are valid. If they are valid, then don't dissolve at all. There is no need. There is no holy compulsion to dissolve. Stay as you are and enjoy life. As most people do, happily.
Sir, हमारे सवाल ऐसा है कि इतने सारे गुरु हैं जिसको देखो सब बात करते हैं, तो जो भी ये बात करते हैं, इनको खुद को सही में समझ में आता है क्या? और अगर समझ में आता है, तो फिर काहे इतना बोलते फिरते हैं?
What he is saying is there are so many gurus and they talk so much. But do they really know what they are talking of? Leave it to them. Leave it to them. See, two things are possible. Either they know what they are uttering or they don't. If they don't know what they are uttering, then ignore them. Are they worthy of occupying your thoughts and your mind space? If you come across a madman, would you let him dwell in your mind for 4 hours? Ignore them. He is not worthy of consideration, right? And then look at the second possibility. Maybe they or some of them do know what they are talking of. And if they do know what they are talking of, see if you want to benefit from them. Otherwise, go your own way. There have been enough teachers who most probably have known what they are talking of, right? And one lifetime is not sufficient to benefit from them. Their numbers are large. So why not just concentrate on them? why focus on the plethora of new age teachers? There is really no need. Have you exhausted the Upanishads? Have you exhausted the literature of the saints? If you have exhausted all that and still you have doubts left, then go to some living teacher. Otherwise, sitting in front of a living teacher might be a trick of the ego to avoid reading the basic texts. Why talk of miscellaneous names when you have Yajnavalkya, when you have Aruni, when you have Ashtavakra? Have these been exhausted in the first place?
Sir, our question was that what teacher ko kya zarurat kya padti hai sab itna bolne ki?
Leave it to them. Might be he is a fraudster, a trickster, so he is speaking just to gain some popularity, earn some money. That's the obvious possibility. The other possibility is he knows a few things and selflessly wants to share with people. In either case, these things should not be your concern. Your concern is your own liberation, right? Your concern is your own liberation. And if liberation is your central concern, then start from the central texts. Finish them off first.
मतलब ये रूल उनके ऊपर एप्लीकेबल नहीं होता
है। You don't need to think so much about them. Are you worried about your liberation or that fellow's liberation? गुरु की करनी गुरु जाएगा, चेले की करनी चेला। उड़ जाएगा हंस अकेला। So you take care of your own liberation. If that fellow is indulging in stupidities, he will bear the fruit.